गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. एज वी हैव स्टार्टेड यस्टरडे चैप्टर नंबर 6 फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट ऑफ नॉट फॉर प्रॉफिट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. टुडे वी विल जस्ट रिकैप्चुलेट द कांसेप्ट फर्स्ट, देन वी विल मूव अहेड फॉर द अपकमिंग टॉपिक्स. सो फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट्स फॉर नॉट फॉर प्रॉफिट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. एज आई टोल्ड यू यस्टरडे दैट not for profit organization are all those organization which are formed not to earn the profit but to render services to their members and to public. Such organization may be the clubs, hospitals, libraries, schools, religious institutes, charitable institutes and literary society, etc. These are the non profit seeking entities exist with a primary motive of providing the services, such as a club provides sports and recreational facilities, a hospital renders medical services, a literary society promotes arts and culture, and an association may be formed to protect the rights of its member. Through the main source of income of such organization is membership subscription. I'll just discuss later about the elaborate topic of membership subscription, that what is it and how the accounting treatment, because a topic related to subscription is very much important from the chapter, from examination point of view. So we will discuss it later, that what is a membership subscription, donation, grants, etc., and maybe undertake the trading activity in order to earn some profit. Such profit is also for the furtherance of the goal of the organization. So I hope it is clear to you that we have did yesterday. All those organizations which are not meant for earning profit, those are known as not-for-profit organization. The example I hope clear to you. Now let's go for that. What, as their aim is not to earn the profit, so they will not prepare the trading and profit and loss account, but they have to prepare their proper records. What is to be done in that case? I told you yesterday. Can you tell me? Yes. Speak aloud. What are the accounts that we have discussed yesterday?
Income and expenditure account.
Income and expenditure account. It is prepared on the place of
trading and profit and loss account.
Very good. Another one is the
debt payment account in place of cash book.
Yes, on the place of cash book, we have to prepare receipt and payment account. Receipt and payment account, income and expenditure account, and another one is balance sheet is to be prepared. Before discussing these accounts, let's see what are the main features of not for profit organization, as it is the theoretical part. Might be you get the theory question, carry one mark in the paper related to this topic, that what is the main features of not for profit organization. The first one is the main aim is service. Their main aim is service. It is formed to set the charitable trust and societies and subscribe. These organizations are called members. It has a separate entity. Not-for-profit organizations are treated as a separate entity distinct from its members. I hope it is clear to you, like in company. Whatever the point, if it is not clear to you, immediately you can ask. Feel free to have your query in any of the point. Managed by elected members. These organizations are usually managed by the managing and executive committee elected by its members. Major source of income. Yes, it's one of the major important point, that what are the major source of income. You might be have the one mark question. Please mark it. Mark a star against this point. What are the major source of income for not-for-profit organization? These are subscription from their members, donations, financial assistance from the government or the form of grant in aid, and income from investment, etc. These are the major source of income. Sixth one, surplus not distributed among its members. Yes, current year surplus form of excess of income over expenditure is not distributed among its member. It's added to the capital fund. Accounts. The organization also have to maintain proper accounts to meet the legal requirement to exercise proper control over utilization of their funds. So these are the various features. After that, the distinction between non-profit organization and profit earning organization is given to us. You have to read it thoroughly. If you have any doubt, you may ask. Here are the financial statements of not-for-profit organization, as we have discussed earlier. These are the number one, receipt and payment accounts. it's floating on the screen. The second one is the income and expenditure account, and third one is the balance sheet. Yesterday we have thoroughly revised it. We just learned that how the format has been prepared. Today we will do the practical part, that how the receipt and payment account and income and expenditure account is to be prepared. See, illustration number one is floating on the screen over here. From the following receipt and payment account, Golden Cricket Club, New Delhi, prepare a income and expenditure account for the year ended 31st March 2019. You may see on the screen as well as in your books as well, the illustration number one. Here the receipt and payment account is in front of you. If you just look at this account, you get it that as you prepare your cash book, it is absolutely similar to that. It started with the cash in hand as on 1st April 2018. It means the opening balance of cash is given over here. If there is any bank balance, it is also shown here. You can see. See, here the cash in hand, the bank balance of the opening date, it is given over here. This is our opening balance. What are these? This is our opening balance. And after that, at the end, the closing balances are with us. It is cash in hand and it is cash at bank. So it means the first point is clear, that we have discussed yesterday, that receipt and payment account gives us the opening as well as closing balance of cash. Now, from this side, the debit side is the receipt side, and all the receipts we have discussed in the feature, that what are the main sources of income of not-for-profit organization. It may be the subscription, to subscription, as it is the receipt, it is shown with two, donation, then entrance fees is there, life membership fees is there, if any interest income, if any local rent is there, it is also to be shown over here. In this way, all the receipts are to be shown on the debit side of receipt and payment account. On the credit side, as this side is shown by buy, credit what goes out, debit what comes in. So buy printing and stationery, buy lighting, buy rent, buy wages, buy telephone charges, buy postage and courier, buy insurance premium, and all the payment made by purchase of furniture, whatever the payments made by the business organization, not-for-profit business organization, are to be shown on the credit side. I hope you remember yesterday I told you the receipt and payment account is the real account in nature. So debit what comes in and credit what goes out. Whatever is received by the organization is shown on the debit side. Whatever is paid on the credit side is shown on the credit side. Clear up to this? See, it is a receipt and payment account. It is a part of the, it is part of your statement. With the help of this, you have to prepare the income and expenditure account. Now, in the solution part, the income and expenditure account is floating on the screen. That these sides are reversed because this account is nominal in nature. So all the expenditure, debit all expenses and losses, and credit all income and gains. So all the expenditure that you have seen, it's a crisscross relation. See, I'm just showing you the half screen. Whatever the expenses, what are the payments, it is shown on in the expenditure. Whatever the incomes are there, it is receipts are there, it is shown on the income side. It is a crisscross relation between the receipt and payment and income and expenditure account. I hope with the help of this, you can make it very much clear that how to prepare the receipt and payment account and how the income and expenditure account is to be prepared. Keep one thing in your mind. In the receipt and payment account, we have shown the subscription of all the years, whether it is 2017, 18, 19, 20. In receipt and payment account, all the receipts and payment are to be considered, whether it is related to the previous year, current year, or next year. But whenever we prepare the income and expenditure account, it always shows only the expenditure or the income related to current year. So you have to take a subscription of current year here only, and no balances of cash has been used in income and expenditure account. I hope the three difference that I have highlighted, the first one, it has a risk cost relation with the receipt and payment account. Second, no cash balances have been shown in the income and expenditure account. Third one, the receipt and payment account shows all the receipt and payment, whether it is to related to current year, previous year or next year. But in case of income and expenditure account, it only shows the expenditure and income of current year only. By balancing both of the side, as the credit side is exceeding, we will get the surplus, which is the excess of income over expenditure. In this way, the receipt and payment account and income and expenditure account is to be prepared. There are so many important terms that is related to not-for-profit seeking organization that should be very much clear to all you people first. Then we will go ahead for the accounting treatment further. See, the first is the subscription. You know, subscription is the main source of income of not-for-profit entity. Any of the not-for-profit organization, the subscription is the major element. It is the most important element of the income. It will appearing on the debit side of receipt and payment account. I hope it is clear to you. It is on the debit side because it is received. And out of its subscription belonging to current year will be posted to the credit side of income and expenditure account, as we did in the illustration number one as well. Second one, life membership fees. The second point is life membership fees. In order to become the member of an organization for the whole of the life, some members pay the fee in lump sum. For example, once in their lifetime, it is a receipt of non-recurring nature, means it's a capital receipt. You know very well, suppose you just join a not-for-profit organization or any NGO and you become the member. And what happened in that case? You have to pay the life membership fees if you want to be the member of that particular. So, the first point that we have discussed, the subscription, the main source of income. The second one is the life membership fees. As the life membership fees is paid once in the life, so that's why it is known as capital receipt of the not-for-profit earning organization. I hope, I just want to recall you once that what are the non-recurring or capital receipts are there. All those receipts, if you remember, in the 11th class, we come to know the distinguish between the capital receipts and the revenue receipts. Capital receipts are all those receipts which are received and helpful for the generation of capital. So all those receipts or the expenditure which are done once in a lifetime of a business or a year for the acquiring of some capital formation, then it is known as the capital receipts. On the another side, which are expenses done on the regular basis, those are the recurring expense or the revenue and revenue receipts as well. So all the capital nature things are to be added to the capital fund. On the another side, in the liability side of balance sheet, and whatever the revenue receipts, it is shown in the revenue. Please mark in your book against the some important point. Please mark an heading on this page, revenue receipts. It's common for everything. Revenue receipts in revenue and revenue receipts shown in income and expenditure account. Capital receipts and payments shown in balance sheet. Endowment fund. Endowment fund is also one of the important item you ever find. It is a fund arising out from the bequest, from gift, income from which is devoted for a specific purpose. Thus, it is a capital received because it is provided with a permanent income. As it is a capital received, where it is to be shown? Please tell me. Yes, it is the capital received. Yes, so it is shown in the balance sheet. Entrance fees or the admission fees. It is received from the new members apart from the amount of the annual subscription. Some people favor capitalizing the entrance fees on the ground that it is collected once for all, and as such, it is not for the recurring nature. However, there are some other people who argued about that. They said every year it is not compulsory that once the, suppose there is an NGO started and people join, the member join there. It never be happened that the member join only in the first year when the business, the organization start. Every year the new members will be joined. That's why some scholars has given, or accountant has given, that theory that it entrance fees is a recurring nature. But some have said it, as it is paid once in a life, that's why it is known as the capital receipts. It is the capital receipt from a point of view of some accountants or the scholars, but other scholars also criticize it and they just consider it as a revenue receipt of the business organization, because their logic is that every year new members add to the organization. It means that every year the firm, the organization will get the membership fees, whether from the other people, it doesn't matter, but the organization is getting the admission fees. Are you getting my point? The organization is getting the admission fees or entrance fees once from one member, but every year the members are joining the firm. So that's why some of the accountant has taken is, or scholar taken it as a capital receipt for the organization. Some has considered it a revenue receipt. So let's see what is to be done with this. In the absence of any specific instruction in the examination, the entrance fees may be treated as revenue receipts. Okay, so always remember, in the absence of any specific instruction in the examination, the entrance fees may be treated as revenue receipt, and it is shown on the credit side of income and expenditure account. However, if the instruction is given in the question to treat it as a capital receipt, then it should be shown on the liability side of current year balance sheet. It is highlighted here in your book. Please mark a star against it. In the absence of any specific information in the examination, the interest fees may be treated as a revenue receipt, and such may be shown on the credit side of income and expenditure account. However, if any instruction is given in the question to treat it as a capital receipt, then it is to be shown on the liability side of the current year balance. I hope it is, concept is clear to you. Let's do one of the practical related to this, then it will be more clear to us. See, illustration number 2. How will you deal with the entrance fees while preparing final accounts of New Delhi Sports Club? See, in the paper it is not given over here and anywhere else that it is the question of the not-for-profit organization. How you identify? It is a question of the sports club. It means it's a question related to club. It is out of the chapter of not-for-profit organization. So, case 1. During the year 2016-17, the entrance fees received ₹1,20,000. Case 2, during the year 2016-17, entrance fees received 1,20,000. It is the policy of the club to treat the entrance fees as revenue received. Case 3, during the year 2016-17, entrance fees is received 1,20,000. It is the policy of the club to treat the entrance fees is capital received. Case 4, during the year 2016-17, entrance fees is received 1,20,000, and according to the policy, 30% of the entrance fees is to be capitalized. It means the partial fees has been taken as capital receipt. Another partial has been considered as a revenue receipt. See how to deal with all these following points whenever given in your question. Let's start with the case one. During the year 2016-17, entrance fees received. In the absence of any information, it is to be considered in income and expenditure account. So it is shown on the credit side of income and expenditure account. Case two. During the year 2016, entrance fees received, but it is the policy to treat it revenue receipt. A specific instruction related to revenue receipt is given to you. That's why it is also given in income and expenditure account. If we talk about the third case, the entrance fees of the club is treated as capital receipt. What does it mean? It is the capital receipt, so it is shown in the capital fund in the balance sheet. Fourth one, partial has been 30% entrance fees is capitalized. What does it mean? It means 70% is revenue is in nature. So 70% is shown in income and expenditure account, and the rest 30% is shown in the capital fund in balance sheet. I hope I'm clear up to this. Let's move ahead with the next point, that is our donation. Donation is classified in two types. One is specific donation, another is general donation. When the donation is received to be utilized for a specific purpose, or a donation built for the building, or it is for the swimming pool, it is always known as the capitalized in nature and shown in the liability side of the balance sheet. But there are some general donations that you receive with the small amounts as well, and it is don't specify any purpose, then it is treated in income and expenditure account and taken as a revenue receipt of the organization. Legacy. Whenever any person died and he don't have any executor, sometimes he just give his will and give his property to the NGOs or any club. Then whatever this type of receipts are received by the organization that are known as legacies. Okay, and legacy, it is not recurring in nature. That's why it is treated in the capital receipt and shown on the liability side. Sale of old assets. It appears on the debit side because we are selling our old assets or the newspaper that whatever we are selling. So whenever the old assets are to be sold, it appears on the debit side of receipt and payment account. It appears, means shown in the receipt and payment account. What you do, assets are selling, so it will be the capital receipt. As such, it should not be transferred to the income and expenditure account. However, the loss on sale of asset is to be shown in the income and expenditure account. Please mark this point in your book. The loss or profit on the such assets is to be shown in the income and expenditure account. Please highlight this point. But whatever you have received or from the sale, it is shown on the asset side. See how. For example, if the book value of the furniture is 5,000, out of furniture of 1,000 has been sold for ₹400. If the furniture of ₹1,000 is sold for ₹400, what does it mean? 600 is the loss on that. That 600 load is to be debited to the income and expenditure account, while the furniture of rupees, there is some mistake. It is 1,000 and 4,000 and 6,000 will be there. And furniture of, it is 4,000 appearing in the books. 1,000 has been sold. So remaining is left with us. That is our, yes. Please mark a text over here that total value of the furniture is 5,000 and 1,000 is sold out. So remaining is left with us. That is 4,000. Okay. So 4,000, 5,000 minus 1,000. We will get the 4,000 furniture that is remaining with us, and it is shown in the asset side of balance sheet. Sale of old newspaper and sports material. There is a difference because newspaper and these kind of things we usually sold. It is a kind of scrap. We regularly do this. So it is shown on the in the income and expenditure account instead of balance sheet. Payment of honorarium. The amount is paid to the person who are not employees of the institution is called the honorarium and it is shown on the debit side of income and expenditure account. Means those people who are not the employee of the institution and we are providing something else to them in any of the form, then it is an expenditure, so it is shown on the income and expenditure account. So this is all about the various important terms that are to be deal in your practical portion, because learning the practical portion, it is very much compulsory to learn these terms. Let's recall once that what we have done today. We just come to know in illustration number one that how the receipt and payment account, we recapitulate the topic that we did yesterday. The meaning, concept, the accounts are to be prepared, that we recapitulate in the beginning. Then we did how the receipt and payment account is to be prepared. After that, we have done the important terms, that is your subscription, life membership fees, endowment fund, entrance fees, how it is to be dealt, we have done in illustration number two. Then after that, donation, legacy, sale of old assets, sale of old newspaper and sports material, and payment of honorarium. These are the items that we have discussed today. If you have any doubt, please feel free to ask. You have to do the practical related to this and prepare the notes of the theory as well. Thank you. Have a nice day.